Hi students, today we are going to discuss the present perfect tense. The present perfect tense structure is subject plus has or have plus past participle. The past participle often ends in ed. For example, finished, decided, walked, jumped, and so on. But many important verbs are irregular. For example, lost, done, been, written, and so on. Present perfect tense is used to describe an action which has been completed, finished, or done just now, or a little time back, but near the present time. It is a sort of link between the past and the present. We also use the present perfect to talk about past events which are still news, actions which are now complete, often with yet and already, then past events with a present result. We have already told that the present perfect has connection with the present. It is a finished action, but it has connection with the present or with now. For example, where is your key? I don't know. I have lost it. It means that I haven't got it till now. See, I have lost the key, which I have not found it till now. Another example, is Sonam here? No, she has gone out. See, she has already gone out. She is not present here. So, its effect is still present. She is not present here. Present perfect tense is also used to describe actions or events beginning in the past and continuing up to the present moment. So, normally we use sentences with certain adverbial phrases like so far, ever, never, and so on. Let us see an example. I have read 50 pages so far. So, it shows the connection up to the present. I have already read 50 pages. That has taken place. But it has connection to the present. An action that is complete, but it has connection to the present. When we ask, have you ever seen a zebra? It means that, have you seen a zebra in your lifetime until now? The present perfect tense expresses a past action, the result of which still continue. For example, I have known him for 10 years. It implies that I still know him. He has been ill since last Sunday. Since last Sunday till now, he has been ill. Another example, we haven't seen her for many weeks. It means that we have not seen her last many weeks and even now we have not seen her. Next, we are going to discuss the use of since and for in present perfect tense. Since and for are often used with the present perfect tense to refer to a period of time up to the present. Since is used with a point in time and means from that point to the time of speaking. It is always used with a perfect tense. For example, Tom has been here since 4 o'clock. It means he is still here. Tom has been here since 4 o'clock. 4 o'clock to now. He is here. Therefore, it is clear from the example that since is used to show a particular point of time in the past to the time of speaking. For is used with a period of time. For example, for 2 days, for 1 hour, for a long time, etc. For used with the present perfect tense denotes a period of time extending up to the present. We have seen the use of since. It shows a point of time in the past to the present. Here, for is used with a period of time in the past extending up to the present time. For example, I have lived in the hostel for 2 years. When I say I have lived in the hostel for 2 years, it means that I am still in the hostel. On the other hand, for used with the simple past tense shows a terminated action. For example, I lived in the hostel for 2 years. When I say I lived in the hostel for 2 years, it means that I do not live there now. Next, we see how present perfect tense is used for a recent action taken place at an unspecified time. For this, we can use words like just, already, yet, and still. Just means a short time ago. For example, would you like something to eat? No thanks, I have just had lunch. Here it means a short time ago I have had my lunch. Another example, she has just gone out. It means she went out a few minutes ago. Next, we use already in the present perfect tense. Already means something happened sooner than expected. For example, don't forget to post the letter, will you? I have already posted it. An action that is done sooner than expected. Next, the use of still in present perfect tense. Still means not yet. For example, he still has not completed his homework. It means that the action is not yet over. Next, we are going to talk about the use of yet in present perfect tense. Yet means until now and shows that the speaker is expecting something to happen or not to happen. In questions and negative sentences, use yet only. Let us see an example. Has it stopped raining yet? Another example. I have written the letter, but I haven't posted it yet.